everybody. This is Donna Lee with Stampin' and Scrappin' with Donna Lee at stampinandscrappin.wordpress.com. And today I want to share with you a birthday card that I'm making. And actually, I have cut enough to make 4 of these cards. So I wanted to share it with you. And I started out with the base of my card I used my Gypsy, and I used the Close to My Heart Artiste Cricut collection, and I designed a square-shaped card, which is 5.5 inches tall by 11 inches wide when it's finished. And then I took a frame, a square-based frame, that also had rounded corners, just like the card base does, also from the Artiste Cricut collection, and welded it to my card shape for the base of my card. Then I welded some shapes, the beach shapes, from the ProverCraft Life's a Beach Cricut cartridge. And I welded all of that to the base of my card, and then I cut it, and I cut 2 to a page. So I have 2 in craft, which is what you're looking at, and then 2 in this pearl white, and this is a Basil cardstock, I believe. The pearl white is Basil. The craft is from, I believe, Hobby Lobby, but I'm not sure. So, I will do a separate video, and I will show you how I designed it on, I'll either do it in the Cricut craft room for you, because I realize that you're not able to get the Gypsy anymore, or I'll just show it to you on my Gypsy, but maybe I'll just do it on the Cricut craft room. I'm not really sure yet. Please excuse my voice. I have an upper respiratory issue going on, but I did not want to not put a video out there this week, so I needed to make this card for a coworker for her birthday, and I understand that she likes going to the beach. So what we're going to do is we're going to do some assembly, but before we get started, I want to show you how I distress these images from Life's a Beach, and I've done some ahead of time, but I am going to share with you. I'll go ahead and distress this one that's down here to put on this card, but I did want to share with you this Adirondack chair. And I'll show you what I did, but I want to show you how distressed you can actually get these. And basically what happens is, you'll see when I do it, is that all these little slats that cut, you can bend them, and then you just add your distress inks. And when I distress, I use what I have. So what I have is, I have a ColorBox chalk ink, and this is alabaster is the color of that. And then I also have a ColorBox chalk in creamy brown. And then my old standby, of course, is ColorBox's chestnut roan. Now you can use black if you want to use black, but you know, beaches are not really black, or at least you hope not. If it is, you're probably not getting in it. Excuse me. So I wanted to show you that. And here's another chair that I've already done. Just doing some different distress. On this one, you can see I put a little more of the alabaster on it. So let me show you how I did it. So I'm going to go ahead and move these off down here. And I'm going to start with the darkest color first. Actually, I'm not. I'm going to go pretty light. So I'm going to start with alabaster, right? And I want to show you, so I'm trying to make sure I get in the camera. But I'm going to take my alabaster chalk. This is wet ink. You could use your craft ink spots, whatever you have. You know, use regular ink. You just need to get a sponge, and so that you can get it on both sides of where we're bending down. And by the way, this bending helps to distress the chair. You know, you've seen chairs that have sat out by the beach, and you know, everything's kind of weathered. So that's the look that I'm going for. There's this little edge right here. If we can get to it and keep it in the camera. Let's see. I'm just going to rub it across there. And then we've got these to do down here. So I'll rub that. This one. And we're just going to do a little bit of bending. Okay. And we're just going to chalk it up. This is, this part of crafting is like my therapy. Cutting things, designing it, that can all get a little tedious. I had to admit when I was designing it this morning, not feeling really great. I got a little bit frustrated. And when I started cutting with this Life's a Beach cartridge, it reminded me why I love my Close to My Heart cartridges as much as I do, because quite frankly, they cut much better than this one. Okay, so now we're going to go with some creamy brown. And I'm not going to apply as much of this as I did the alabaster. So I'm just going to be kind of brief about how much color I add, just a little bit, because I don't want to cover up everything I just put on there. So I'm just kind of quickly going down, letting the color catch where it does. And I'll do a little bit on the seat here, right there. One more. Let's see. So I'm going to come around the edges where it's down, where it would, you know, be hitting the sand, and go around and give it just a little bit of the edging along the arms. But, you know, sits out in the sun, it gets a little weathered. Do you see how bending it is making this look a little more rustic? I love that effect. I think it's going to really add some great dimension to our card. Okay, so here we are with the darkest color. This is the chestnut roan. Yeah, it's my favorite. So really, I'm just going to kind of hit and miss here. Get a little bit down here. I don't want to overdo it with this color. I just want to add a little bit. And I've got the dropsies today, so I hope you all are enjoying the beginning of fall. September is about to be over, and with September, that also means that the specials for September are about to be over with Close to My Heart. So follow the link over to my blog if you're watching this on YouTube and check out the specials, because it's National Stamping Month and we have a 3-stamp set for $10 with any qualifying order for $50. So here's our chair. You can see by bending it that we've given it a little dimension. I'm going to get some ink in between there, just to give it a little bit of extra dimension. Okay, so that's going to go right here. Now, I am going to do our umbrella. And I've got the chestnut roan in my hand, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. And here's our umbrella. Isn't it cute? And this glitter paper, you want to make sure that your mat is sticky, because I'm here to tell you, my machine does not like it. I struggle with the glitter paper, so I just had to clean off my mat really good and make sure the stickiness came back. So, hope I'm in camera. I'm trying to do this and keep my eye on the camera too. So, okay, so that's the chestnut roan color. And then I'm going to go just with the alabaster. And I'm going to add a little bit, just a little bit, just to add variation in color. And it's not a whole lot, so you're not going to be able to see it a whole lot, but it does add a little bit of a shadow. So let me get it on here. There's our umbrella. And there's our chair. And let me take our shovel. Here's our shovel. Can you see that? A little tiny thing. I'm putting a good bit of that because, you know, it's in the sand. It needs some, needs to look like it's got some sand on it. And then I'm going to go for the lighter brown, the creamy brown. And I'm just going to go around the edges of it. Let me get in camera here. So, today's video is not using the Art Booking Cricut Collection, which is the newest Cricut collection from close to my heart. But we're just taking a little break because I needed to make this birthday card. And it's all good. We will be back to Art Booking this week as well because I'm still working on my 10x10 travel album using the Art Booking Cricut Collection. So I've got to get that finished and I have a long way to go. But it will be a great album once I get it done. Okay, so got some creamy brown on that. I want to put some chestnut brown around the edges on this one. Not too worried about the top there. And I'm just folding it where they have these little cut lines, partially cut lines, just to kind of give it some dimension. So, but you'll figure it out how you like it and how you don't like it. So, all right, and we've done our little sand already. So let's see. Okay, now I want to show you the shells, and I've already done these to save time, but this is what they start out looking like. So it's just this. I don't know if you can see the die cut in there or not, but there's some little marks. Okay, so I have already gone ahead and I've taken a sponge and I am using some coral ink, and I've just inked around the edge and kind of gone somewhat in the middle, but not too much. And then I took the creamy brown, okay, and I'll do this on the plain one, and I just started bending just like I've done with the chair and the bucket, everything else, right? And I am just going to bend it where those cut lines are and just add some color, because you know when you pick up shells, they're just all kind of colors. So have that. And this chestnut roan is a little bit dark, so you don't want to go hog wild here. You want to go light. So I'm just going to lightly go around and just put a little bit of, almost like a vein of color right along the inside edges of that. And sort of stop and look at it and see where you might want some more color. So have that. Now I'm going to come back. I'm going to get my coral on my ink pad, on my sponge, and I am going to sponge it all around the edges and wherever else you want to put the color. It's totally up to you. So that's how I did the shells, right? So like I said, I already have those done. And then we also have this cute little sand dollar. Everybody goes to the beach, loves to find a sand dollar, but y'all put them back. Y'all put them back in the ocean. They are living creatures. Don't take them out. Now, if they're already dead, that's one thing, but if they're alive, let's put them back. You can buy fake ones that are already, I don't know if they're fake or dead. I don't know where those people get that stuff that deal with shells, but you know, they're living creatures, and I just think we ought to leave them alone. And I'm not putting any coral on the sand dollar because I've never seen one that had any coral on it. So I'm just going to add a little bit of, I'm going to bend this down, try to get right there in the middle, and then I'm going to bend it this way, right? I'm just trying to bring out those lines. I know you're saying, but you're bending it, and you're going to have to make it flat. Well, yeah. I don't really do flat cards, y'all. I don't. So, I like a lot of dimension, and I don't have to worry about mailing this one. Thank goodness. But if I did, you know what? I'd put it in a thick envelope, ask them to hand cancel it, and I'd pay extra postage on it. It would be just fine to do that. Okay, so here we go. All right, so we've got everything inked and ready to go, right? Now let me pull in my other two shells over here. I'm going to move this up. Here's my bucket. Now, I've picked out this piece of paper. This is old piece of paper. And I measured this piece of paper to be 5x5. Okay. And I am going to lay it, adhere it underneath my background. So what I'm going to do is turn this over. And I basically, because my card is 5.5x5.5, 5x5 is a perfect center to this side of the card. So I am going to just center it, which means I need to put adhesive on this side, or I could put adhesive down here, but I'm just going to do it on here. And then if I need to rub off the adhesive, I can do that from the front of the card with a little adhesive eraser. So I'm just running adhesive around the edge, right? Right there. Alright. So, got my card laid down right here. And putting this in here. Very good. Alright. So now we have our background. Oops. Alright, so I'm going to feel around my edge, and yes, I did get some adhesive too close to the inside of that. So, and I don't want it to be sticky. So what I'm going to do is run my little, I don't know if y'all can see what I'm doing or not. Let me get over here. So it just kind of runs it around, and it'll pick up whatever adhesive and ball it up. There's some right here too. But you know what? That might actually work out to my advantage, but I'm gonna take it off. You might want to be a little more careful with your adhesive. So, and I will come back and clean that up off camera a little bit more, but I don't want to be wasteful of your time. So, let me make sure we're back in camera. So here we are. And what we're going to do is we're going to put our umbrella down first. And I want the umbrella to have a little bit of dimension at the top. So back here, I've got these tiny little double-sided adhesive, little tiny squares. They're really perfect for this sort of thing. So I'm just going to put like three on here. And I'm not going to put them where they bend because, you know, I kind of want to keep it. I want to make it movable if I can. So I'm not sure that's going to really fit right there, but I'll put one there. And then I had some that I had cut in half. So I'll take one of those. right? And I'll put that on this side, on the skinny side. So, okay. All right, so we're just gonna peel this off the backing to the little adhesive squares. I picked these up at a stamping show last year, and I've really enjoyed using them. I'm gonna use my EK Success little glue pen. I'm just gonna put it some glue on the long part, right? And first I'm gonna get this down where I want it. And then I'm going to push my this part down. So there we go. All right. Well, that's actually not going to hold. I don't think it doesn't really want to. But it's okay. We're going to put adhesive on the back of this chair, and it's going to get covered up anyway. So here's our chair that we're going to use. And I'm not going to pop up the chair. Okay, I'm going to put that flat. So for that, I'm just going to use my little tape runner, wherever it went. There it is. Okay, so we're just going to put some adhesive, fair amount, because you want it to stay down. Don't be stingy with your adhesive, people. Send somebody a card. You do not want it to fall apart, right? So, because we've kind of bent this up, it kind of has some wear and tear to it. Makes it look a little more realistic, which I like. Alright, so there we go. So we have our umbrella, which is popped up. We have our chair, which is flat. And we're going to go ahead and put our sand pail down. And we are going to pop that up. So I'm going to put, I don't know, two or three on here. These little pop squares. My goodness. All right. Excuse me. So sorry. All right. And there's our pail. Now, I have our sand that we need to put on here. And I think for the sand, I am just going to run some liquid adhesive using a glue pen. And use whatever you have. And you want to get it good and wet. A lot of glue on there. This will give us a chance to get it down and kind of slide it into place where we want it to be. Okay, and while that is drying, and I'm going to push down on it a little bit. I don't know, can you see that? You see how it's looking so far? There we go. Isn't that adorable? I just love these cards. Scenic cards. I like this one. But I love the beach, so I'm going to come as no surprise to anybody that knows me. I grew up in Miami, Florida. So I am a Floridian by birth, a Georgia girl because I want to be, and yes, we are playing LSU today, and go Dawgs. Don't know what the score is. I don't have the TV on, obviously, but I hope we are in a favorable position. I'm definitely rooting for the Georgia Bulldogs, and yes, we do root for our Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets, as long as they are not playing Georgia. So, we always go for our local team. And I'm trying to decide how I want to pop these up, these little shells. So, I'm not quite sure how I'm going to do that. I think I want to pop up that one. So I'm going to put this one down flat. And the dog is barking, one of them. I have four dogs. I have one rescue who is staying here. Hopefully he will get adopted soon and go to his forever home. His name is Scrappy, or that's what we call him. His new family will probably rename him. He's a cute little terrier mix. He's probably less than 2 years old. And he would be great in a single woman household. He is very much possessive of women. And he does tolerate men, and he tolerates toddlers really well. Because I have grandchildren who are toddlers, and he does great around them. So praying that the Gwinnett Society for Humane Friends can find him a home, a good forever home, somebody that'll love him and give him the attention that he needs and deserves. So if y'all are animal lovers, say a little prayer for my Scrappy, that he gets adopted soon. We have three other dogs, but they are large dogs, and four dogs is chaos is a good word. Three large dogs and one little terrier. Life is very, very busy around this place. Okay, now we have our little sand dollar, and we're going to put him right here. Okay. And do I want to pop that up somehow? I think I do. But I wanted it a different height, so I'm going to grab a Stampin' Dimensional from Stampin' Up that I have. I love Stampin' Dimensionals because they are, let me get this in camera, see how thin they are? I like that. And it will be a different height than the rest of them, so it'll work perfectly. All right. So there we have it. We have our, everything is put down. And we have a shovel left to do. And I'm going to put some liquid adhesive using my EK Success glue pen. Right under the pail, right here. And just push it down. And there we are. We have put it together. I'm going to fold over my card. Should have already done this, but I'm sorry. And there we go. Get it in the frame of the shot. There you go. A finished beach themed card. Now I will tell you, I intend to come in here because this one is going to be for a birthday. I've got three others that I'm making to keep in my stash. And I think I'm gonna stamp, or I'm going to cut, either one or the other, I'm not really sure, but I'm gonna put happy birthday right in here. I may stamp it and emboss it on there. So I haven't quite decided how I'm going to do that yet, but let me zoom up so you can see the detail. The sand bucket. You know, you're walking along the beach and the sun is shining down on it, and you just get that glint. Everything just gets that glint. That's what we were trying for here with this pearl basil cardstock. And I think we hit the nail on the head with this one. So, thank you so much for coming by today. I know this was a longer video than normal, but I hope you've enjoyed it, and I hope you're inspired to use what you have. And be sure to check out my specials, because we only have another day to get the specials for September. So I've got to hurry up and let this upload and get it posted for you so that you can see it. And I wish you all a very crafty weekend and happy fall. Bye-bye.